In this video, I will explain how we can use Pyxel Resource Editor to create basic sprites and how to draw those sprites on the screen. If you haven't seen the previous lesson, make sure to check it out. The link is in the description. Let's start by explaining what sprite is in the first place. Sprites are two-dimensional images that are used to represent player or non-playable characters on the screen. Sprites are also used as building blocks for the map itself. Sprites can be static or animated, but we will usually work with static pictures. Many game engines use simple PNG files to store sprites, but Pyxel uses its own resource file format. To edit Pyxel resource file, we use Pyxel edit resource file name command. You don't need to specify file extension in this command. Pyxel will figure it out itself. In our case, there is no such file, so Pyxel will create it for us. Let's have a look at what you can do in the resource file editor. First tab is the sprite editor. Second tab looks very similar, but it is the tile map editor. We will cover tile maps in the future lessons. Then there is music editor and composer tabs. In order to save file, we click Save button or Ctrl S keyboard shortcut. So, going back to the sprite editor, I will create very small sprite, 8x8 pixels, but you can use 16x16 pixels or even more. For the most retro style games, 16x16 is usually enough. In case you make mistake, you can use Undo button or Ctrl Z keyboard shortcut. Sprite editor has basic instruments such as pencil, fill, select, as well as a selection of very basic shapes. In general, the interface is very intuitive, and you shouldn't have any issues drawing sprites here. When you're done with your sprite, don't forget to save your file. Let's now write some code to draw the sprite on the screen. We start by reading the resource file. There is a mistake in the code now. For this command, we have to specify a resource file extension. Then, we will use function bleed to draw sprite. Let's see what parameters it takes. First two parameters are the coordinates for the sprite on the screen. Next, we specify the index of the image bank. In our case, it is 0, but there can be up to 3 image banks. Finally, we specify the index of the image in the image bank as well as the width and height of the image, 8 pixels in our case. Okay, after fixing the resource file extension, we can now run our game. We see sprites at the top left corner. It is where X and Y are actually 0, according to the most game engines. For people who did lots of math, it is a bit confusing, so make sure to remember that. Now, let's add some animation and move our sprite. To do this, we need to make sure that X and Y coordinates are changing. We will create X and Y fields in the class. Make sure that they are added in the constructor before Pyxel run, otherwise it isn't going to work. In the draw function, we will just draw our sprite at the current X and Y coordinates. In the update function, we will update the coordinates, just like that. Now we can draw sprite and even move it across the screen. Well done! In the next lesson, we will use keyboard to move the sprite around. If you find this video useful, please hit like button and drop me a comment. It was Test Encoder. See you around.